Have you ever tried creating a multiplayer game where the server and the client see things differently and things were out of sync? Well, sit back and relax because today I will show you the correct way to replicate. Let's start off by creating a new Unreal Engine project. Click on Library and launch your preferred Unreal Engine version. This example, I clicked on games and then I chose the third person template and I named the project Flag Rep. If you enjoy watching UE5 tutorial videos, don't forget to like and subscribe. First thing first, let's clear up this area by deleting the default meshes. Then we're going to start off by creating a new blueprint actor. I'm going to call mine Flag 1. I double click it to open it. And then we're going to add a cube for the pole. I should have chosen a cylinder for the pole, but for this example, I went with the cube. The main goal is to make it thin and long. You can change mode by hitting spacebar to change it from rotation to moving to resizing. And now we're going to add a cone. Use it as a so-called flag. Then we're going to drag it up so it can be up on the pole. Then we're going to rotate it negative 90 degrees and push it outward for all to see. I wasn't happy with the height of the pole, so I made it taller. And then I dragged the flag all the way to the top. To showcase how to do replication right, I need some type of trigger. So I added a box collision. We are going to make it bigger and we're going to drag it in front of the pole so it could trigger as you walk to it. And voila, we are done with the first flag. Don't forget to compile to check for errors. Now we're going to drag our creation and drag it to our level. I then rotated it to 90 degrees so it could be in front of our spawn points for an easy trigger. I pushed the flag slightly forward and the spawn point slightly back to add room for the other flag. Now that we're done positioning the first flag, duplicate the flag blueprint and call it flag 2. Since we created a copy, just drag it out and add it to your level. Adjust the height and rotate it 90 degrees so it can be facing the same way as the first flag. Make sure they're on the same grid so they can look asymmetrical. I separated them a bit so they can have a gap in between them. And then I hit play so I can test them out visually, and I was happy with the results. Now this is where we're going to start adding replication coding. For the first flag, I'm going to create the most common way people do replication. It is not wrong if you know what you're doing, but there is a better way. Click on the event graph and let's start adding blueprints. I've seen many YouTube examples showing this method. Like I said, it's not wrong for quick burst effects, but it is wrong when keeping things persistent, like if somebody joins mid-game. Now we're going to click on the box collision, and on the right side, we're going to add on component end overlap. In the event graph, we're going to drag out the cone because we're going to make it change color when you step on the trigger. We're going to drag from the cone node and set a material. I went to the viewport to check on the material that the cone currently has. I clicked on the magnifying tool, and to my surprise, there was a second material, which we were going to use for this example. I selected the orange material, and then I went back to the set material and clicked on the arrow pointing left. That will take our selection to add to the node. So now every time we hit the overlap trigger box, the flag should turn orange. To finalize the flag, I made sure that the flag was replicated. By check marking replicates and replicate movement if I do decide to add movement to this object. I then clicked on the cone object because this is what we're going to change colors, and I also replicated that object. I compiled and saved to check for errors. Then I clicked on the level to test. But then I decided to add a do once so it won't be triggered more than once. I compiled and I hit play and everything worked as intended. When we overlap on the trigger box, the flag should now turn orange. Now we're gonna test this with multiplayer. Make sure you change the number of players to 2, and then on net mode, change it to play as listen server. I then hit play and I adjust the screens so I can have a better view of both viewports. And like I said, this method does work. When I overlap with the trigger box, the flag now turns orange and you can see it on the client side and on the server side. If you have any questions or are getting stuck, feel free to leave a comment below and I'll reply as soon as possible. Now we're going to close out and test the server. And again, everything works great. But what will happen if we reconnect or if we join mid-game? On console, I hit the tilde key and typed in reconnect. And here is the problem. As you can see, the flag turned blue and it's not persistent. The client sees the flag as blue and the server still sees the flag as orange. This is a big problem if you want things to be persistent, especially when people join mid-game or reconnect. So now it's time to do it the proper way. Let's go into our content folder and double click on the flag 2 blueprint. Go into the event graph. Click on your box collision and add on component begin overlap. Before I forget, we're going to replicate flag 2 by clicking on self and clicking on replicates checkmark along with replicate movement. And then we're going to click on cone and we're going to checkmark components replicates. To do this properly, we're going to create a bool variable and call it flag change question mark. For best practice, I always like to add a question mark for the boolean. I then dragged out the flag change variable and clicked on set. I checkmarked the node and set it to true so that when this node is ran, it will be set to true. And this only happens when somebody overlaps with the box collision that is in front of the flag. Just like the other flag, I'm just gonna allow this to run it once by adding a do once node. I attached everything together, compiled, and double check that everything was ready for a test. Before hitting play, I remembered that the boolean needed to be replicated. So I clicked on it and I set the replication to rip notify. When you add rip notify to a boolean, it will automatically create a function for you. Double click the function and here we can add the function to perform and it will be replicated. And guess what? It will be persistent. So now I'm gonna demonstrate the right way by setting the material change in this function. I went to flag 1 blueprint and I copied set material node. Drag out the cone to set it to the set material target. And then we're going to connect everything together. Since I copied the set material from flag 1, I do not have to set the material. Now it's time to test. Let's hit play and it's time to test with the server. I ran to the trigger box on flag 2 and everything worked as expected. Now for the true test, let's reconnect as a client. On console, I typed in disconnect, which disconnected me from the server and connected me to my server, which should, in theory, make the flag blue. I then reconnected to the server session, and guess what? The flag is still orange. And guess what? Any new clients connecting to the server will see the object the same as everyone does. Just to double check, let's type in reconnect and see what happens. Instantly, you'll see the flag is still orange. If you still don't believe me, I'm gonna do it a second time. I went to the console and hit reconnect, and guess what? The correct flag to the right stayed orange and the incorrect flag to the left stayed blue. You now know the correct way to replicate. Don't forget to like, subscribe if this video was useful to you. It will really mean a lot to me. Now for more UE5 videos, click on the playlist to the right.